Hey folks, welcome back to the Pride Collection. We're here to show you all the awesome new lesbian shows and movies coming out and streaming this month. It's all about spreading the love, so grab your gay bestie and let's have a blast together. We're kicking it off with a teen coming-of-age throwback. Booksmart is all about two high school besties, Amy and Molly, who realize they've been hitting the books too hard and missing out on all the wild teenage antics. So, they embark on this hilarious one-night adventure to make up for lost time before graduation. And let me tell you, the representation in this movie is on point.
We have to go to a party tonight.
What?
Nobody knows that we are fun. We didn't party because we wanted to focus on school and get into good colleges.
And it worked.
Put me to your lips.
Hand sanitizer.
Check.
Chapstick.
Check.
Mace. Listen, it is very important that you keep the safe.
Oh!
Is your
night.
Yes,
yes. What is this?
Re-ask the questions!
Oh my God,
how old are you?
Does not matter!
What you two have is special.
We are gonna show each other how much we care about each other.
We'll probably just do a Korean face mask.
I don't need to know all the words.
Catch Booksmart on Peacock from March 1st. This next one will blow your socks off. The Favorite is a historical drama with a wicked twist, and it's got Emma Stone and Olivia Colman, so you know it's going to be good. Set in the 18th century, it follows the power play between Queen Anne, played by Olivia Colman, and her close confidants, including Emma Stone's character, Abigail. But here's where it gets juicy. There's this intense love triangle brewing between them, full of manipulation, intrigue, and yes, some steamy scenes too. It's like a lesbian soap opera set in a royal palace.
I apologize for my appearance. I hoped I might be employed here by you as something.
A monster for the children to play with, perhaps.
It is important to make new friends in court, is it not?
You're so beautiful.
Stop it, you mock me.
If I were a man, I would ravish you.
You have become close to Abigail.
She is a viper. You're jealous.
You must send Abigail away.
I do not want to.
You can watch The Favorite on Hulu from March 1st. All right, buckle up for Hannah Gadsby, Gender Agenda on Netflix. Award-winning comedian Hannah Gadsby hosts this global comedy special that's truly one of a kind. She's curated a lineup of the world's absolute funniest genderqueer comedians. And let me tell you, it's a riot.
Yes, Tom, I'm trans, can you tell?
Don't answer that!
That was a test, you're passing, am I?
There's something about being the only woman that walks into the space in a men's suit that makes those straighties think you're the most interesting person. Like, the women are coming up to you like, I had a sexual experience with a woman once.
Calm down, lesbians.
I can't walk the dog while I'm drunk, it's too much. She starts barking at people, I start yelling at them too, like, who we mad at?
I struggle with anxiety, but I don't want to say that anymore because it sounds so negative. From now on, I say my mind sparkles with imaginary danger.
You can catch it on Netflix from March 5th. All right, let's dive into Poor Things. With Emma Stone leading the pack, this movie is bound to be a hit. Picture this. A quirky dark comedy meets Victorian drama. As Bella pieces together her past, she forms an intimate relationship with Toinette, a fellow female character in the film. Cue the love, betrayal, and steamy moments.
Tell me, where did she come from?
I shall. For it is a happy tale.
I am Bella Baxter, and there is a world to enjoy, circumnavigate. It is the goal of all to progress, grow.
A woman plotting her course to freedom.
Watch Poor Things on Hulu from March 7th. All right, let's talk about Girls 5 Eva. This show is like a hilarious love letter to girl groups, and it's got something special for us lesbians too. Enter Paula Pell, who plays the divorced lesbian dentist Gloria. She brings this quirky charm to the group dynamic that's just so relatable. The series follows a 90s girl group that gets a second chance at fame in their 40s.
Gonna be famous like ever, 'cause forever's too short.
Girls 5 Eva is back!
We need to do something big to get noticed.
That should be us up there.
I'm doing a graffito. Ugh.
Summer, no. Posters, no. Move now.
Oh, no. Ma'am, I'm so sorry.
It's out on Netflix on March 14th. All right, buckle up for The Girls on the Bus on HBO Max. This series is like a thrilling ride through the world of journalism, and it's got some seriously queer representation that we're here for. One character you'll want to keep an eye on is Lola Rahi, played by Benham, who's a queer reporter. In one scene from the trailer, she's locking lips with Terry Hu, a non-binary actor, in an elevator, and let me tell you, it's got us all buzzing.
OTR.
On the record, baby.
No, it's off the record.
All eyes on me.
Hey, wake up. It's only our democracy at stake.
Get out of here.
You're a polar bear.
I'm a what?
You look sweet and cuddly. But really, you're a fucking killer.
To being stuck on that bus with you crazy bitches.
Yeah.
You can watch The Girls on the Bus from March 14th on HBO Max. All right, buckle up for Bodies, Bodies, Bodies. This film is like a whirlwind of chaos and humor, especially for us lesbians. Picture this. Sophie, played by Amanda Stenberg, is taking her girlfriend B, portrayed by Maria Bakalova, to a remote vacation house for a hurricane party. But when a dead body unexpectedly shows up, the weekend getaway takes a wild turn.
If you draw the piece of paper that has the X on it,
you are the murderer.
Everyone else has to avoid being killed.
What is that?
Xanax, you want one?
Yeah.
What is happening?
Our friend is dead. So if you could just, like, not escalate this situation, that
I'm not escalating. You're holding the knife and you're moving your hands while you talk.
That would be so fucking obvious if I were the killer.
David.
More.
You're always gaslighting me.
You fucking trigger me.
You are so toxic. Relax, relax.
You're silencing me.
You can stream it on Netflix from March 20th. All right, let's take a look at Beyond the Aggressives, 25 years later. This documentary is like a reunion with old friends, as it's the sequel to the 2005 film The Aggressives. It reconnects us with some of the masculine of center New York-based lesbians of color who were interviewed in the original, bringing their stories full circle. From the vibrant ballroom scene of the 90s to personal interviews with these trailblazing individuals, this film is a powerful exploration of identity and resilience.
The film, I spread my wings.
It's grown from being like cocky to like confident.
My mother will tell you,
there's never a time where I ever felt like a woman.
Octavio is really inspiring. First and foremost, he's a mom. He always tries to remind me that I'm his son.
My son is my everything.
I still live my life in an unapologetic way.
I want people to know the life that I went through as a transgender male immigrant.
Chin ended up in immigration detention because of a mistake made by the U.S. government.
Simply because he's transgender, period.
It's available to stream on Paramount Plus from March 30th. That brings us to the end of this video, beautiful people. Thanks so much for joining us. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like and subscribe for more.